Hey guys, my name is Sarat, and in today's tutorial I'm gonna show you two ways on how you can create chromatic aberration in After Effects. So if you've been on a lifelong quest to finding out how to create chromatic aberration in After Effects and you wanna know how to look like a 70s gangster or someone from the Alien movie, or maybe you wanna kill Sarah Connor, then I'm gonna show you how to look like that guy. Chromatic aberration now! Ha! Okay, so I'm gonna show you the first technique. So you go to the video, you go to effects and presets, and you type shift channels. You take shift channels, and now you gotta duplicate the video three times. So we're gonna be doing an RGB split right now. And with the first one, I'm gonna leave just the red channel one. On the second one, I'm gonna leave just the green one. So everything but the green one goes off. We're leaving the alpha. And with the third one, we leave only the blue one. So, okay, so now we have a blue video, a green video, and a red video. Okay, so right now we need to go to the top two videos and change the blending mode to add. Okay, so right now we have the video from the beginning. Nothing has changed that much. But if we go and start moving the video around, basically, we're just changing the position of the top video. You can see what's happening. We're getting chromatic aberration. We don't want to get that much chromatic aberration, so I'm just going to make it subtle. I'm going to open the position on those two, and I'm going to change the position slightly. You can see what's going on right now. 18, let's say, and let's make this 1078, and you're getting something. Obviously, you can start moving those around and you can find the look that you like. So I'm moving the green one now. Okay, maybe if we move this one, okay, something like that. Okay, actually I do like this. It's really subtle, and obviously you can make it a lot stronger, depends on you. Let's say we make it stronger, so we just see how the effect is gonna look. Okay, so it's a lot stronger chromatic aberration. Right now we're getting a bit of a problem that at the end, you know, at the edges, we're getting black or maybe too much chromatic aberration. See, here you don't get anything, so you need to scale the videos a tiny bit. So I'll just scale them just a little bit, maybe let's say 101. Okay, there you go. So right now it's fine. And we have chromatic aberration. And obviously you can do something else. If you don't move the position, if you just change the timing of the videos, if you just move them by one frame. And you take it to the beginning. You're gonna get some dynamic chromatic aberration, which might be interesting as an effect. You can try that as well. Okay, so let's see the next effect, how it's gonna work. I'm gonna use the second video. For this one, we're gonna take optics compensation, add optics compensation. I'll just set it to 10 and reverse the lens distortion so you can see what it's doing. It's basically distorting the image at the edges. So I'll just leave it to 10, maybe let's say 15. And then we go here and type glasses, 3D glasses. Okay, that's the one. And we have to change the left view to our video, which is number 4. So we're changing it. And we're changing this to balance colored red blue. Okay. And right now we're getting chromatic aberration at the edges. So we're not getting any chromatic aberration in the middle, but we get quite a bit at the edges. And you can change the compensation and it's gonna change the amount of chromatic aberration you get. Obviously, if you distort it a lot, you'll get like a crazy effect. If that's what you're looking for, that could be cool. Depends again what you want. Okay, so a quick tip that I have that is gonna help sell the effect a bit more is to add an adjustment layer. And to this adjustment layer, we're gonna add noise. Okay, I'm gonna put it at 10%, and I'm also gonna add Gaussian blur. And the Gaussian blur, we don't want too much, so you can see the noise. Gaussian blur at 3 maybe. Okay, that's fine. And you can see how this works. Right now we move the timing, so we're getting the effect with the timing, not with the position, but you get the idea. Now I'm also gonna add a letterbox, so I'll make a new solid, I'll duplicate it, change the scale of this one to, let's say, 75%, and we're gonna change the alpha matte on this one. I'm gonna put the adjustment layer over the letterbox, and we're getting a bit of blur here on the edge of the letterbox as well, which is a bit more old school. I like that. You can obviously add a bit more blur, but it starts ruining the image. It's up to you. Okay guys, thanks for watching, and please subscribe, like the video if you enjoyed the content, leave a comment below if you think I've missed something, and I'll see you in the next one.